Section 91(2), 5 billion naira for presidential elections. Section 91(3), 1 billion naira for governorship. Section 91(4), 100 million for senatorial election. Section 91(4), 70 million for House of Representatives election. Section 91(5), 30 million for State House of Assembly. Section 91(6), 30 million for Chairmanship Area Council. Section 91(7), 5 million for Councillorship. It is worthy to mention that all issues raised by Mr. President, ranging from election sequence down to cross-referencing error, shall be addressed. For further clarification, let me reiterate that the issue of card reader has always been part of the electoral amendment process.
And going back to the election expenses, Mr. President, like they said, presidential election, 5 billion naira. Now, how many polling booths do we have in Nigeria? And if you take the number of the polling booths and just take the number of agents that you are going to deploy, and take maybe a minimum of 10,000 or 15,000 naira per agent, on agents alone, you will be coming to maybe something close to this, this 5 billion naira. So, Mr. President, I don't think it is quite realistic to consider this. And I want to urge my colleagues to have a critical look at it with a view of expunging it altogether. That is 5 and this 4. Because it will just pose a serious problem and a bottleneck to everybody. I thank you, Mr. President.
The thing is that with this provision, you can win an election. Somebody will allege that you exceeded the limit and you start defending yourself not to go to jail instead of going to do your work. So in the final analysis, I suggest that this section should be expunged completely, because I don't see the effect it will have. Even a presidential election, 5 billion naira, I don't know whether it's cost of billboard or vehicles. So it doesn't make sense at all. And if we put it in our law, we are just putting it for the sake of putting it there. I know that the intention is to limit the monetization of a democratic process, but there's no way to enforce this thing. So instead of putting a law that will make you be dragged to the court as soon as you are declared winner, you keep paying the lawyer, running around, calling witnesses, and sometimes spend more than the money you are talking about in defending yourself over a frivolous allegation, which the court at any event will eventually dismiss.
Section 145. Let me just read. If at the point of display or distribution of ballot papers by the commission, a candidate on his agent discovers that his name, the name or logo of his party is omitted, a candidate on his agent shall notify the commission, and the commission shall A, postpone the election to rectify the omission, and B, appoint another date to conduct the election, no less than 90 days. I think this is very, very dangerous. Because what happens that will happen is that somebody who believes he will lose the election will raise an objection without even consulting the other candidates. He writes to INEC, and the INEC can believe him and then postpone the election. And then it becomes an isolated election where you cannot be able to determine what will happen. So I think it's very, very dangerous and unfair to the rest of the candidates. So I suggest that if you look at this section 140, there are previous subsections there that suggest that seeks to ask candidates or their parties to look at the logo, because they print the logo and display them before the election. Then you are now required or expected to either object or approve of it. That's the provision of 140, I think 143 and 4. So I believe that at that point, INEC should be able to rectify it. And if they don't rectify it, maybe the officer in charge should be punished. But not a situation where someone comes on my election day and say, my name is not well spelled, the party's logo is not well done, and then INEC will now use that as an excuse to postpone the election a week or two. Then you now see all kinds of security agencies, they will now come to that constituency and make sure you don't win. So I think that we need to do something about this.
Senate needs to take a very critical look at election expenses. Very critical look at election expenses. I think a major problem of this democracy now is the amount of money that is being spent So here we have about, for senatorial, that is for our purpose, we are talking about 100 million to be spent. Who will enforce this? The whole thing is very loose there. Over there, nobody takes account of anything. And the society is there to milk everybody dry. And Mr. President, you see, it's something that we need to address holistically. Holistically. Otherwise, we are lawmakers. We don't have to make a law that cannot be implemented. It's something that is unimplementable. So we need to carry major stakeholders like the security agencies, the INEC itself, everybody, before we arrive at a figure that we are not here for joke. Well, whatever we do here, we want it to be taken very seriously as something that can be implemented.